You want that intricate, intimate relationship between the grapes, the soil, the microclimate. If they feel good, they give the best to each other. And that invisible talent is what makes the difference between growing grapes and growing outstanding grapes. Look at this place. It's a place of beauty and serenity. And I like to think that my grapes grow in a place of serenity and calm. I think it helps them in their tremendous challenges. You know, the poverty of the soil. This is an old volcano where you have plenty of rocks and stones everywhere. The slope makes natural drainage. The root system has to go 47 feet down, stressing the vine to yield tiny, concentrated berries. You see, you and me, we get our complexity by confronting life challenges. The grapes, they get theirs by confronting this specific piece of land challenges. No challenge, nobody home. In this vineyard Wildcat, we grow Cabernet Sauvignon, Cabernet Franc, Merlot, and Petit Verdot. And all these grapes are going to be used in our new wines with a vintage 2010. And I have to tell you something. I am the harshest critic of our wines. And I'm super excited. I love them. These wines are so aromatic, it's unbelievable. The power of the finesse, the balance that is extremely difficult to find for nice drinking now, but also extraordinary, remarkable aging potential. You know, we are on elevation, so we are cooler. So we have not one dominating flavor, but layers and layers and layers. That contributes also to the complexity of the wines. So when I now release this 2010 for you, I am so proud, but I'm happy. From the bottom of my heart, I'm happy that I think I have done something that I've never done before.